$92,000. That's how much it costs to give your child a supposedly free public school education, according to new figures out today. Factor in back-to-school costs, inflation and the cost of living, and it's forcing some Australians to make hard choices.
If you've spent the last couple of weeks getting the kids ready for school, this will be familiar.
Sports jacket is $72. Formal skirt, $61. Sports shirts, $30. $84. $23. $72. $27.50.
Across Australia, parents are expected to spend $12.9 billion in back-to-school costs this year. That's $1,100 per kid for basic supplies. And then there are all the other costs. Things like school camps, excursions, sports equipment and transport. And it's getting more expensive. Jamie's youngest is about to start Year 9. She's noticed a huge difference compared to when her eldest was at school.
Definitely, life has become harder and it's just coming to a point where you can't always afford everything for your children and be able to give them everything that they want or need.
And it's not just Jamie. A new survey by the Smith family found nearly 50% of families said their children could miss out on necessities like uniforms, school shoes and technology this year.
All up so far, I've probably spent close to $900, and that hasn't included an iPad that she needs as well.
50% of the parents and carers that we spoke to, we're concerned that they wouldn't be able to provide a connected digital device.
The cost crunch is forcing families to make tough choices.
There are going to be times where you're going to have to put things back and sacrifice, but you do that for your children.
Jamie is worried that despite those sacrifices, the odds might be unfairly stacked against her daughter.
Mia's concern at the moment is not having that iPad. You know, all her assessments, everything is on that iPad. So I am a bit concerned that I'm not going to get there, but I'm sure something will come up and we will get one.
Students who turn up to school with that resource deficiency start behind the eight ball at the very start of their schooling, and that has a cumulative effect over years and years through schooling.
So if costs are piling up and you need help, what can you do?
I'd really encourage you to connect with askizzy.org.au. That's a website that connects you up with the sort of services that you may need.
Reaching out to everybody that you possibly can, friends, family. We're all in this tough time, all of us. It's not just me, it's everybody.
Well, Jessica Rudd is the acting CEO of the Parenthood. She joins us now. Jessica, obviously everyone feels the pinch at the start of the new year, but I wonder if you're monitoring a spike in frequency of yourself saying mum and dad aren't made of money or saying to the school money doesn't grow on trees.
Yeah, look, everyone's really feeling the pinch at the moment, and I think more so than usual. We've got this situation with this rising cost of living where after Christmas and all the bills and everything else and grocery prices through the roof, the last thing you really want to be hit by is having to go and get a new pair of school shoes or find a new jacket from somewhere. And if you don't have the hand-me-downs from neighbours or friends or older siblings, then you really have to fork out at this time of year, and you add a school camp to that, and suddenly that's a lot of pressure on the family budget.
And the tech stuff is really pushing people to the wall. If a kid is going to school without those essential supplies, what's the potential impact, Jess?
Yeah, look, it's just not fair. You want to have a system in Australia where you've got equal access to public education. And it's not equal if parents are having to fork out huge amounts of money in order to create that equality, because, of course, not everyone has that cash just sitting around. So for individual kids, that's a really hard ask. Imagine rocking up at school and wondering if you're actually going to be able to go on camp, or maybe you might not be able to go on that excursion that everyone else is going to. And you don't want kids missing out like that. Every kid, regardless of what their parents do for a crust, should have the same start in this country.
Now, when I went to primary school, it was free. Now, granted, it was one of the worst primary schools in Victoria, according to the Herald Sun, but whatever. Whatever happened to free education?
Yeah, we need fully funded public education, don't we? Because really, if we're in this situation where some kids are missing out because of their postcode or their socioeconomic background or whatever it is that their parents are going through, you know, we're letting people down, we're letting kids down, and we're letting down our future workforce. We need a universal public education system. And that applies to early childhood education too.
Well, Jessica, on that note then, how do we even approach trying to level the playing field?
Look, I just want to see better funding for public schools. I want to make sure that we're giving every kid the same start and the same chance in life. We want to take the pressure off of families because at the moment they're really feeling the pinch and you shouldn't be in a situation where you're just praying for someone to kind of throw an iPad your way because that's just not likely to happen. That's a huge amount of stress for parents to be walking around with. It's not good enough and we need to do better.
Jessica, good to see you. Thanks for your time.
Thanks for having me, guys.
It's crazy, isn't it? When I was at school, our computer room, the only air-conditioned room in the whole school, that's where we went to use the computers. But now you've got to have not just an iPad, a laptop as well, and then you have to keep upgrading it. That is a huge expense for parents. And also blazers. Blazers are everywhere now. I mean, we had six blazers in our school library that we would all share for special occasions.
Oh, you'd share them?
Yeah, like in different sizes. Like the whole school would share these six blazers because they knew that we couldn't afford it. Like there was lots of families struggling.
Yeah, my son's starting prep this year in Victoria, of course, prep the first year, and there's even a thing on the form where you can contribute to the building, to the school building.
Yeah.
So I thought that's what tax... Isn't that why you pay tax? Like, it's a shame that schools are having to put their hand out
and ask
for
the,
more help.
Get on the tools and get down there and help build, Cody.
Have you seen these soft poets?
It's a media hands right there. Yeah.